Hi everybody. In this video, we're going to be solving for the Lewis structure of ClF4+, which is tetrafluorochlorate cation. To easily remember the steps for finding a Lewis structure, I have them in the top right-hand corner of our screens now. So let's get right into the problem. First, we need to find the total number of valence electrons that are present within our compound. So remember our trick to easily remember how many valence electrons every atom in groups 1A to 7A has. We look at the group number, the column that our atom resides in, and that'll tell us the number of valence electrons that atom has in a neutral state. Therefore, since both chlorine and fluorine fall in group 7A, we know that each of these atoms will have 7 valence electrons. Additionally, since our compound has a net positive charge, that means that we have one less electron than we would expect. Therefore, our compound in total will have 34 valence electrons. Next, we need to find what is going to be our central atom. I have listed the electronegativities of both chlorine and fluorine here. Remember that we said before, we typically use our least electronegative atom as our central atom. Therefore, it is clear that chlorine is going to be the central atom in this compound. Now that we know our central atom, we need to create a skeletal structure of our compound. So, let's place our chlorine atom in the center and our 4 fluorine atoms all around the chlorine, and add in our valence electrons for each atom. Now, let's place in our relevant covalent bonds to connect all of our atoms. Alright, to validate our Lewis structure of this compound, let's check if the total number of valence electrons matches the number that we found in step 1, and that all of the atoms that need to are satisfied in terms of the octet rule. So, counting our valence electrons, we have only actually used 32 valence electrons. Therefore, we are going to need to place another 2 electrons somewhere. But where, you may ask? This could be confusing to some students, as it would appear that all of our atoms are satisfied in terms of the octet rule. Well, chlorine is actually one of our special atoms that can expand its octet, and actually take on more than 8 valence electrons. Therefore, the central chlorine atom can actually take on the remaining lone pair of electrons, and we have now used all 34 of our valence electrons. So, both of our conditions of validation are now met, as we are using all of our 34 valence electrons, and all of the fluorine atoms are satisfied in terms of the octet rule. And, as we said, chlorine is now using an expanded octet. In terms of molecular geometry, our tetrafluorine chlorate cation will be a trigonal bipyramid, which will look something like this. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.